This video will show community water system residents and water operators, as well as non-community water system operators, how to take a lead and copper sample. Before you take the sample, let the water sit for 6 to 12 hours. Do not use the water during this time. Use the water normally the day before you sample. Don't sample after a vacation or if the building is vacant. If you are a resident or from a community water system, take the sample from a kitchen or bathroom faucet that does not have treated water. If you are from a non-community water system, take the sample from the tap listed on your system's site plan. Take samples from the cold water tap of a faucet that is used regularly, but remember not to use the faucet for 6 to 12 hours before you take the sample. When you're ready to take the sample, remove the cap from the bottle and position the bottle under the faucet. Slowly turn on the cold water as if you were filling a glass of water. If your bottle has a line, fill the bottle to the top line. If your bottle does not have a line, fill the bottle to the neck. Fill the sample bottle up to the line or the neck. The lab will not be able to use your sample if the bottle doesn't have enough water. Screw the cap back on the bottle. Make sure the cap is on securely. Turn the bottle upside down to make sure the water does not leak. You may tape the cap to seal the bottle. Complete the label on the bottle. Complete the tap water sample form. Your utility cannot accept samples without a completed tap water form. Let your utility know if you need help to answer these questions. Attach the form to the bottle using tape or a rubber band. Contact your water utility as soon as possible to arrange pickup details. If you have any questions, contact the person who sent you the sample bottle. Thank you for participating. Your samples will help ensure that we meet all standards for safe drinking water.